it's part of the Stockholm syndrome. But you know, I think there was a sense that, you know, when he started asking me, oh, you know, they look for what's the backstory behind, you know, where this person came from, or what's this person's backstory? You know, when I got to actually share with him the deeper connections of why I think I got into K-pop, or I remember Cody White, our first conversations we had about K-pop is that you guys were very inspired by how hard Twice works, and it makes you want to work harder yourselves. I think when you kind of realize that, oh yeah, okay, yeah, great, they have great visuals, right? It's so glossy, amazing dancing, amazing beauty. But when we get into the human aspects of it, and what makes them human, that was my eye-opening moment, and that's what I think got people to pay attention a bit more, when they're like, oh, yeah, this isn't just pop music in the sense that pop is fun and bubblegum and lovely. Like, pop music means something to me, to whoever it might be, and we're at the end, we're all humans in that way, and there's something that connects us as humans. And that's where I think, you know, I love when I can get people to get that. Yeah, I love these people. Love, okay, yeah. I mean, like, I love these artists, these people, whatever they are, as human beings, because I love what they represent in that way, too. And I get inspiration, and I learn from them in that way. So it feels amazing. There's still a lot of work to be done. You know, a lot of people are like, but they don't speak Korean, so how do you get it? And I'm like, oh my gosh, it's much more than that. You know, everyone understands a smile, a thumbs up, a laugh, a tear. You know, there's so many things that connect us way more than just language or just pop music that has a meaning. And yeah, I think we unfortunately are out of time. We're so sorry. This is a very good question.